really nice food after it takes. This is called Flamer.
Trouble.
The song is called Page Two. It's sort of like a letter to a fanzine. True Adventures of Two Girls in Love, about these teenage lesbians, and she asked me a long time ago to use that song in this movie, and finally I met her, and she was telling me, the movie just got made, it'll probably show here, I don't know, sometime in the next couple months, but she finally told me what it was, what part of the movie it was, and I guess the one girl is in love with the, she's kind of, I don't know, poor, and she's in love with this girl who's kind of rich, and so anyway, she works at the gas station where the girl always goes to get her car full of fuel, and so the girl has such unrequited love for this other girl, and she goes home. The girl finally gives her a book, and it's Walt Whitman's Leaves of Grass. So she goes home, and she puts on her Walkman, and she starts reading the book, and it's Page Two. So I was really excited, because like the last movie that I think I ever saw about teenage lesbians was The Trouble with Angels, so I'm ready for a new era dawning. Okay,
right.
Well, all right.
Is the kid drum too loud?
I don't think so.
The drums are never too loud.
The drums are never too loud. Rock! True. This song is called Unattached, and we dedicate it to Fifth Column. Thank you. This song is called Transatlantic Telephone Call. It has a subtitle of, in parentheses, or our love costs $1 a minute. So that's for anybody who's ever kind of gotten in trouble with their parents for having a gigantic phone bill, or gotten in trouble with their roommates, gotten kicked out of the house for non-payment, lost their job, because suddenly the boss looked and there's like, you know, $1,200 of calls to Canada.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you. like kick some massive ass. What's the name of the kid that this belongs to? Evan. Evan, what does AYJ mean? Anyway, it's a school night, duh. I'm into it. There was this band in Portland a long time ago called the Neo Boys, and they used to sneak out of their apartments, or I mean their parents' homes, to go to play shows, so I'm into it. In fact, I think I'm just going to move home, back to my parents' house, and sneak out to play shows. That's my new thing I'm going to do. All right. I'm starting a new thing. It's called Arrested Development. I'm going to go right back into it. This is actually a song about going to school and seeing people at school that you think are really rad. It's called Motorcycle Boy. From me in my youth, that one time when it was my birthday and we could all, in my family on your birthday, could always choose like whatever the meal was, like it was a special birthday meal, and I chose for my special meal a TV dinner. those little trays. This is called Diopter.
1, 2, 3, 4!
Yeah.
much.
Should I try to hide the way I feel inside? My heart for you, would you say that you could try to love me too? Esther. We're going to play it far from Kim. Because every time we come here, we stay in our house and leave all our stuff in Buffalo, and she provides us with such excellent kicks. The last time we were here that summer, we had a fashion show at our house. Just me and Heather and Kim, we just had a fashion show. And last night, we just raged. I mean, strewn with bottles this morning. It was just... I don't remember what happened. That's why I can't tell you what happened. I just can't remember. That's how hard you reach.
Thank you.
thank you to the club and to Moa Queen, especially for the drums. Moa Queen, you're really lucky to live in a town where Moa Queen is. That's all I can say. Support any band that at the end of their set says, "We've got some fanzines for a quarter." Then you know that is a good band. We're gonna just sing one last song. And I did want to actually clear up a slight misconception. I don't know if you read the newspaper or not, but there was this little article in it about me and Heather. And there's just one thing, and it's not a glaring error by any means. It's a great article, I was very happy, but there was this part at the bottom when it was talking about this very famous incident last August when we played here, and I broke 6 strings on my guitar. And because I was, I don't know why. I was rocking, I guess. But anyway, it says, "For now, Lois Mofo has no greater ambition than to top her last Toronto show, during which she broke 6 strings." Now, this is the part I have an issue with, because it says in parentheses and quotations, which means I said it, supposedly, "We were really pumping." Well, I would just like to say that those words never came out of my mouth. Now, perhaps what I said was, and I'm almost positive this is what I said, "We were really punking out." So, we don't do any pumping. None of this kind. None of this. We do pump gas. We have been pumping gas.
Gasoline nation.
Gasoline pumping is all right. But pumping, what does that mean if we're pumping on stage? Are we playing like this? And that's why I broke all the strings. My guitar was just so pumped out. I don't know. So that's the only thing I just wanted to clear up, because sometimes you just have to really be, you've got to jump in the fray and say, "No, I didn't really say that. I said something else." And if I had time, I'd go through with everybody all the things that I've supposedly said on America Online, which I have, but I don't think I'd ever have enough time for that. But thank you again for coming. It's been really, 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 really fun to be in Toronto. And, this song is called "Stop It." Yeah. We have six t-shirts, so if anybody wants them.